What's up guys, Sal here. So the Galaxy S23 Ultra will go all Snapdragon this year, and for the first time in almost a decade, the Snapdragon chip is going toe-to-toe with Apple's latest A-series Bionic chipsets. But we have a new development that has caused quite a stir in the tech world, and for good reason. And here's why Apple should be worried about this development. You see, Apple's success with smartphone chips or laptops isn't magic. It's a result of excellent engineering, a good lead time over its competitor, and of course, custom chipsets. Unlike Samsung and Qualcomm, who use off-the-shelf stock ARM cores, Apple creates their own custom cores, which gives them the freedom to make bigger chipsets with bigger cache size. Although the new Snapdragon Agent 2 has closed the gap with the A16 Bionic chip in terms of performance and efficiency, but in the long run, if Samsung and Qualcomm wants to stay ahead of Apple, then they cannot just use off-the-shelf ARM chips and expect it to perform better, because Apple can just increase the number of cores or cache size to regain the lead. And that's the advantage of using custom chipsets. So in order to truly beat Apple, both Samsung and Qualcomm need to replicate what Apple is doing and do it better than them. And that's exactly what Qualcomm will be doing. You might have heard of Qualcomm's acquisition of Nuvia, a company founded by veteran Apple engineers and chip specialists who made the M-series chips for Apple. Apple's M1 and M2 chips have been praised for their performance and efficiency when compared to other chips like Intel's, and it has made Apple's products more attractive to consumers. But with Nuvia's acquisition, Qualcomm has vowed to disrupt the semiconductor market and make better chips than Apple's M-series chips, and we have our first details of what this new chip is capable of. According to this well-known developer, this new chip, codenamed Hamoa, features 12 in-house cores made up of 8 performance cores and 4 efficiency ones. For comparison, the latest M2 chip from Apple has 8 cores, 4 being efficient cores and 4 being performance cores. Interestingly, the memory and cache configuration for Hamoa is also claimed to be similar to the M1 chip. And most importantly, the new chip's performance is extremely promising. And what's even more interesting is that the chip is set to feature support for discrete GPUs, which is a big deal for ARM-based devices. Apple's M-series chips cannot do that because they have integrated GPUs. So while the chip are great for productivity-based tasks, they aren't good for gaming. But that's not going to be the case with Qualcomm's new chip. You can possibly pair the latest Nvidia graphics card with it to get the best gaming performance, while also getting the best CPU performance. But unfortunately, we'll have to wait a year to see this new chipset. The developer mentions that the chip is set to be released in 2024. But the future looks good for Qualcomm and even for Samsung, because Samsung is Qualcomm's biggest customer. Qualcomm is not going to limit Nuvia's expertise to just the PC market. It will trickle down to their Snapdragon lineup as well, which will improve Samsung's Galaxy lineup quite substantially. Not to mention, Samsung has a laptop range of their own, and the Nuvia chips will help Samsung better compete with Apple laptops with M-series chips. To know the prices of the Galaxy S23 lineup, click here, and I'll see you there.